I'm going to be adding two tomatoes to our outdoor grown thing, and both of them started life as suckers that I just shoved in some soil. Drainage holes, essential. So as I said then, I've got my outdoor tomatoes. For anybody that's not been following along then, hashtag is grow along with Eli, and it's a whole experiment with tomatoes to see if I can actually get a decent tomato crop growing them outdoors in my garden here in Scotland. It's not traditionally how you would grow tomatoes in a lot of Scotland, because you need a really good sunny spot that's sheltered for them. I don't have a lot of that free in my garden. So I'm trying these little tiny dwarf tomatoes in the hope that they're really small plants, they give little cherry sized fruit, excuse the wind, they give little cherry sized fruit. So I'm hoping that means they won't need as much heat and sun to ripen, they'll ripen a bit quicker. Now, what I'm going to do today though is not little dwarf cherries, so this is completely off the book. I had never planned this for the experiment, but what happened was I saw a video by Steve over at Greenside Up, and he was saying how he actually plants the suckers that he pulls off of his tomato plants. So
now I'm going to focus in on this side shoot here just to show you, but if you look at the stem, we have a leaf coming off here, and we have a side shoot between the stem and the leaf. And you come up further up here, the stem comes up here, and we have this leaf. And between the leaf here and the stem here, there is another side shoot. Just take hold of that and take hold of the stem and just very gently pull it off. Now all we need to do is plant that.
It is a famously known thing, is that a word? But it is a really well-known thing that basically tomato plants will root very easily. So what he does is he just sticks the suckers straight into the soil. Takes like a week, 2 weeks, and you've got beautiful little plants with gorgeous root systems. I thought, I'm going to try it. I had a random sucker I pulled that had got quite big. I thought, I'm going to give it a go and see if this actually works. And it does. So I've got a plant that I wasn't expecting. Didn't have to buy it, didn't go all the effort to grow it. It's no loss if it doesn't work, so it's just going to be a cool part of the experiment. So there's two pots you can see, because it worked once and I was really intrigued, I did it again. So I've now got two, and they are two Brad's Atomic Grape, which are apparently really temperamental, so I think they're going to be an awesome challenge to see if they can grow in my garden. So I'm going to do that. Now, it's nothing exciting, you know, I'm just going to fill pots with soil and put the plants in them. However, I thought this might be handy for you guys. And yes, there is still one white tub that Kate hasn't painted yet, so this has got all my lovely compost in it. I think Kate is going to paint it, she hasn't yet. I've never mentioned this before. You guys have now followed me on the journey and I've talked to you about how I make my seed sowing mix for when I'm sowing seeds. I've spoken to you about how I then up that to a potting mix for when I'm moving these little seedlings on to little pots up to about that size before I plant them out in the final position. I've never actually talked to you guys about when I plant into big pots and containers, because there's something I do then. So what I do, I have my standard potting mix, but I make a more nutritious version of it, because if this is the final place these plants are going to go and they're going to stay there all season, I want to make sure there's enough nutrition in that soil to last them all season. So that's what this is. I add a little bit of fish blood and bone to my potting mix with my compost just to boost the nutritional value. And fish blood and bone is just a slow release fertiliser. It breaks down a bit slower, so it will last a decent period of time. That's all that is. Right. I'm going to fill these pots up and get them planted out. This is going to seem crazy. The bright pink. Kate painted this the bright pink. It matches with all the pots we've got around the garden in lime greens and pinks. But we found having the white tub here just stood out so much. This actually ties into the garden a bit better and doesn't stand up. Doesn't stand out as much. Which, given it's bright pink, is quite weird. You wouldn't have thought that, but it does. Massive big poles, because as I said, these are indeterminate, or cordon or vine, which just means they will grow quite tall. Now, in the greenhouse, I don't restrict the amount of trusses that my plants have, because they're being watered and fed so well using my quad grow system that the plants can cope. Traditionally though, if you're growing outdoors, the kind of traditional thing is that you nip them at 4 or 5 trusses, just to kind of help them to get those tomatoes to ripen so that you get as many ripe tomatoes to eat as you can. I'm going to do that because I've never grown outdoors before and I don't know how well this is going to work. But theoretically, if you can make sure that nutrition and water and stuff is perfect, you wouldn't need to do that. But I'm going to stick with tradition, so hence I've got the big canes. So let me just get this ready. Now, as I said, I've added fish blood and bone to this compost potting mix to add nutrition, but I'm also going to add a little bit more just at the bit where the roots are going. So as the plant grows over time, there's going to be nutrition in here. And right now, for where the plant roots are, there'll be some nutrition breaking down into there now as well. Right, this was the first little truss that I tried it with, and I showed everyone on Instagram last week. It was about, off the top of my head, I think it was about 9 days old or something when it started to really look like a proper plant again and amazing and upright and stuff. It's now about a fortnight old, and wait till you see these roots. Look at that. Proper tomato with proper root system. So there we go. So as always, let's get him in there, nice and secure. And I forgot to put the pole in. Forget my head if it wasn't screwed on. There we go. Now, I'm banking that it'll be okay with the pole because it's going to be up against the shed wall and I can secure the pole if I need to. But that is number one, Brad's Atomic Grape. I'm just putting them there just now out the road. This is number two. Now you can see he's looking a wee bit wimpy and poorly and kind of, yeah, just basically wimpy and poorly. He's only been in this pot for a few days, so he's not going to have a root system or anything yet. But I'm just going to get him in here just so he's in his final place, because it's really hot and it's not great in the greenhouse for this little guy. He's struggling. So exactly the same treatment. Some fish blood and bone. This time, don't forget the big pole. And we have two Brad's Atomic Grape tomato plants grown from trusses that would have been thrown in the compost pile. And instead, they're going to be part of our outdoor tomato experiment. I will keep you guys informed. There'll be lots of pictures going with the hashtag #GrowAlongWithEli. If you're growing along with me, share the pictures of your tomatoes as well. And we'll see how we go It's going to be really exciting. So this corner's becoming a lot bigger than we were expecting, and we're going to struggle to get in and out and do stuff here now. May have to rethink it. But we have got then the Lita, the Olapolka, the Rock Caption, and now we've got two Brad's Atomic Grape. It's going to be interesting to see how it goes, because I've said before, these guys have all picked up so much over the last few weeks. They looked awful when I first put them out. So I'm really chuffed to see how these guys go. It's going to be really interesting with the two Brad's Atomic Grapes, because they're a different type of tomato completely. And I'm actually a wee bit excited. Now, it's going to be cool as well. You can see the little guy at the front there, how awful and poorly he looks. Watch this space, because I guarantee he's going to perk up really fast. I was amazed by this. Do please comment away below and tell me how your grow along with Eli tomatoes are doing. Which ones are best for you, the Olapolka, the Lita, or Rock Caption? What's doing well in your garden? If you haven't followed me along on the whole tomato growing journey, or even if you're just new to growing tomatoes, some awesome hints and tips for you. Watch this video next, and I take you from seed to harvest and all of my tips in between. See you guys.